So when I completed college, I had the dilemma whether I wanted to go straight into medical school or whether I also wanted to do research, because when I was in college, I got very excited about the brain and had, again, a professor who told me that he felt that in the next century, all the major advances in medicine and in research were going to be in the nervous system, particularly in the brain. So when I finished college, I decided, well, maybe I'll get a Ph.D. and an M.D. And so I started my graduate studies first, and I began in a neuroscience program at the University of Michigan. Fell in love with the brain completely. And when I started medical school, there was no doubt. From the very first day in medical school, I said I was going to be a neurologist, and I've loved every day of it. One of my passions as a neurologist is also to be a neuroscientist. So I'm very privileged to have a fairly large laboratory that I work in with about 30 young people who do research with me. And we've become very interested over the last 5 years in using stem cells in regenerative medicine, particularly in neurodegenerative diseases in neurology. Lou Gehrig's disease is one passion that we have. We're also interested in Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, and Huntington's disease. So from our basic findings in the laboratory of how stem cells can promote nerve regeneration and protect nerve cells from dying, we've actually begun a clinical trial using stem cells in patients with Lou Gehrig's disease. So it's very exciting because what I do in my basic science laboratory, I can then transition over to my clinical practice. And ALS, or Lou Gehrig's disease, is one of the disorders that I am very familiar with, and I take care of hundreds of patients with that disorder. And so I'm able to serve as a bridge from the basic science to the clinic. I can go to the clinic and tell my patients what I've learned in my basic science laboratory. I can go back and tell my basic scientists what my patients have taught us, and they teach us so much. And so stem cells is one of the major avenues I see translating in the near future from my laboratory to a real clinical and therapeutic, I hope, option for patients with Lou Gehrig's disease.